Good morning, children. In our previous class, we read about lesson number 4, that is forest, our animals, our friends. In that class, we read about various types of animals. Those animals are wild animals and domestic animals. These are the wild animals. In wild animals, we also read about extinct animals. Extinct animals means the animals which are no longer living. They have disappeared from the earth. Then we read about the endangered animals. Endangered animals are those animals who are in danger of becoming extinct. Then children, we read about wildlife trade also. The illegal hunting and killing of animals to use their body parts is known as wildlife trade. And because of this only, many animals are becoming endangered. Then we read about protection of wildlife. In this protection of wildlife, we read about the Wildlife Protection Act, which was enacted in the year 1972 by our Indian government. We also read about food chain and food way. Food chain means it is a process of who eats whom. And here I showed you one food chain. That is, leaves are being eaten by caterpillar, caterpillars are being eaten by frogs, frogs are being eaten by snakes, and snakes are being eaten by owl. Here we read about food web also. In food web, various types of food chains are there. Many food chains are there, and in this picture we saw there are 6 food chains. Then we should care for the animals, and how we can prevent the cruelty to animals, that point also we discuss. Now, here you see, people for the ethical treatment of animals, that is PETA. It is written about PETA. That is, full form of PETA is People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals. It is an animal rights organization. It is the largest animal rights group in the world. Means this organization fights for the rights of the animals. Animals have also the right to live, and we are not allowed to kill the animals. PETA's slogan is, animals are not for us to eat, wear, experiment on, or use for entertainment. Means we cannot use animal to eat. We cannot use their body parts to cover our body. We cannot do any experiment on them, or for our entertainment also we cannot use them. This organization focuses on 4 core issues. Means this organization, we are talking about PETA. This PETA is People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals. This organization focuses on 4 core issues, on 4 main issues. Which issues? Factory farming, then fur farming, animal testing, and animals in entertainment. On these issues, this PETA organization work on it. And your today's homework is, you have to write, do you know? Only 2 do you knows are in this lesson. One is this. You have to draw this slogan, this poster also. In a very neat and clean manner, you will draw this poster of logo of this PETA. And then what is written here, do you know? That you will write there. Understood? Now next also, one do you know is here also, Kenya's Masai Mara. This do you know also, you have to write. And what is this do you know? Kenya's Masai Mara, one of the world's most famous wildlife sanctuaries. In our previous lesson, we have read about wildlife sanctuaries. So here, Kenya's Masai Mara. Kenya is an African country, and here one place is there, Masai Mara. It is the world's most famous wildlife sanctuaries, and it was recently voted one of the seven wonders. You must be knowing there are seven wonders in world, and Kenya's Masai Mara is also one of them. In our country, what is, which monument is one of the seven wonders of the world? Taj Mahal. It is man-made, but here it is, Kenya's Masai Mara is one of the seven wonders of the natural world. Means where the world is in its natural form. However, it is getting seriously threatened by human activities. Means human beings are disturbing there also. So children, this two do you know, you have to write it, and in that paper you have to draw the logo of PETA also. Now today we will discuss these keywords. Draught animal. Draught animal means an animal used for pulling heavy loads. You must have seen camels. They carry loads in the desert area. And then bullock cart, horse, these are also used to pull the cart. Now, second, endangered. That is, we have read about extinct and endangered animals. Endangered means the animals which are in danger of becoming extinct. Extinct means what? They are no longer on the earth. Once upon a time, they were living on the earth, but now they have disappeared from the earth. Then extinct. Extinct means no longer on the earth. They do not exist. When no member of a species, species means a particular type of creature. That is, when no member of a species exists any longer, they are known as extinct. Extinct means they are not on the earth now. Then next keyword is habitat. Habitat means a place where certain kind of plant grow and animal live. Means it is a living place of plants also as well as animals also. Because of those particular plants, those particular trees only, animals live there. Next is oyster. It is a type of shell fish that has a rough shell. Means it is rough from the outer side. The shell is rough with two parts, and it is eaten both cooked and raw. Cooked form also it can be eaten, and raw form also. Pollute. Pollute word, from this pollute only, the word pollution. Pollution means you must be knowing, making dirty. Pollute means to make dirty. We human beings pollute the air also. We human beings pollute the river also. That is known as water pollution. When we pollute the air, that is known as air pollution. Then next is species. Species we have read here. In extinct, when no member of a species exists any longer. And species means a group of very similar plants or animals. Means it is a type of very similar plants or animals. Then tusk. Tusk. Whenever you see elephant, you must have seen the extra long tooth that grows outside the mouth of elephants. is known as dust. Dust is used for what? For making jewelry, for making decorative pieces. Then veterinarian, that is a doctor that looks after, heals and treats animals. Our doctor is different and animal's doctor is different. So veterinarian means doctors that looks after, heals and treats animals. So this is only keywords. These keywords you have to write in. So children, your today's homework is you have to write keywords and then these two, do you know? Which two do you know I have told you to write? One about Kenya's Masai Mara and the another about this data. So understood? This lesson has been completed. In short, let us revise the lesson and then in our next class, we will do ABC parts of this lesson. These are the animal products which we get from the forest, from the animals. These are milk. This is milk. Milk we get from cows and buffaloes. This is honey. Honey we get from honeybee. Here you see animals are being used to pull the carts. Then how animals are useful for us? Silk and wool we obtain from the animals. We obtain leather from the animals. That is pearls that is used as jewelry. That are also obtained from oysters, sea fish. Then many types of fish, prawns, lobsters and crabs are used as seafood. Then animals like horses, camels, elephants are used as means of transport. And many dogs assist the police in various search operations. Then some animal wastes are also being used as fuel or compost. Now wildlife, those animals which live in the forest. These are the wild animals, monitor lizard, then tiger, then elephant, wild boar, giraffe and lion tail macaco. Now about extinct and endangered animals, you have read extinct means those animal species which are no longer living. Endangered animals are those animal species that are in danger of becoming extinct. And those endangered animals are African elephant, tamarind, panda, then bacterian camel, then golden lion and bald eagle. Then dangers of wildlife trade. Why animals are being hunted? So here the points are, elephants are hunted for their tusk. North and South American bears are also being killed for their gallbladders. Rhinoceroses are being slaughtered for their horns. Musk deer is becoming extinct because it is being hunted to obtain kasturi. Then a variety of mountain goat is hunted because its hair yield a very expensive variety of wool and that wool is pashmina wool. Then tigers are hunted for what? For their skins which are to be used to decorate walls by hunters. And some superstitions are also there. Tiger claws and teeth are worn as jewelry by many superstitious persons. Then legs of frogs are eaten as they are considered to be a delicacy. Then caviar, another very costly delicacy, is made from the unfertilized eggs. Now we should also protect wildlife. Then we have read about food chain and food web. Food chain means a process of who eats whom. Food chain, one food chain is here. Food chain is found in all the habitats. And in food web, in one food web, many food chains are being found. Now how we can prevent cruelty to animals? We should not throw polythene bags in the garbage. We should not put birds in cages and fishes in aquariums. We should not visit a forest, park or garden. And while visiting, we should not remove eggs of birds from their nest. Then in summer season, we should put some water in an earthen bowl and keep it outside for the birds to quench their thirst. Then if we have pets, we should love and give them good care. Then we should talk to our friends about how to treat animals with kindness and respect. And then we should visit and support our local animal rescue organization. So that's all for today. This lesson has been completed. In our next class, we will do ABC. But your today's homework is, two do you knows are there in this lesson. You have to write those two do you know. Here in this do you know, you have to draw this logo of PETA also. And then you write the keywords in your science notebook and submit it on our WhatsApp group. That's all for today. Goodbye.